Mr. Fitzsimmons, did you kill Elliot Tompkins?
He was shot.
What did you say?
I said, did you kill Elliot Tompkins?
No, I didn't kill Elliot Tompkins, but I can't say I'm sorry that is dead.
And so Neil Fitzsimmons, Canada's self-made millionaire, builder of dams and bridges, tunnels and pipelines, was today formally charged with the murder of Elliot Tompkins, chairman of the Canadian National Resources Board. The Crown maintains that Mr. Fitzsimmons beat Mr. Tompkins to death following a violent argument over Tompkins' public announcement that he was going to award the $250 million contract to build a new pan-Canadian pipeline to a competitor, Bordine Enterprises. In lengthy and often heated arguments today on the matter of bail, Fitzsimmons was represented by John Davis Ogden, a leading Toronto attorney, who argued that all of the prosecution's evidence was circumstantial. Nevertheless, Fitzsimmons was ordered held without bail. On the lighter side of the news today, a Montreal woman who refused to pay taxes because she claimed her house was actually a stable for horses.
Operator, this is 555-4209. I'd like to place a call to Lincoln, Nebraska, in the States. Yes, area code 402. The number is 303-3100.
The Jefferson Keyes lives in Nebraska?
I doubt that he's ever been to Lincoln, Nebraska. But the trunk lines into Lincoln are never busy. Oh, it's ringing. Now, Jeff will take a chance on just about anything except a busy signal. And it could cost him $1 million.
303-3100. May I help you?
Yes, I'm John Ogden. I'm calling from Toronto. May I speak to Mr. Keyes, please? It's urgent.
One moment, please. Mr. Ogden, may I have your mother's maiden name, please?
Look, Mr. Keyes has worked with me before. Her name was Mason, Geraldine Mason.
And your place of birth?
Vancouver, province of British Columbia, Dominion of Canada.
Thank you.
Mr. Keyes is in his plane.
I'll put through a radio patch.
He flies his own plane.
I would, too, at his fee.
Oh, that's $1 million if he succeeds. Zero if he doesn't. And he pays all the expenses.
Mr. Ogden?
I have Mr. Keyes for you. Go ahead, please.
Jeff.
John Ogden. Can you hear me?
I could hear you a lot better if you stopped shouting, John. What's on your mind?
Come up to Canada. I have a client who's in a little bit of trouble. And I'd like you to get him out of it. Neil Fitzsimmons, you know?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the man who wants to pave the earth and paint it green, according to Time magazine. What's he done?
Murder, according to the Crown.
You call that a little trouble?
Jeff, I need your help.
Well, murder's not the specialty of the house. You know that, John. What you want's a good private detective. Now, there are a lot of good men in Toronto, and I'd be happy to recommend a few.
Jeff, I've used them all.
I hate to put it this way, but you do owe me a bit of a favor.
I'm glad you hate to put it that way, because it just smacks a touch of blackmail.
Jeff, a man's life is at stake.
And I owe you a favor. Where are you?
I'm in Toronto. I'll pick you up at the airport.
No, don't bother. My car will be there.
I'll see you at 10 a.m.
tomorrow morning, City Hall steps.
Don't tell me, let me guess. We're filing a new flight plan.
You've been eavesdropping again, Tony.
Think of the time it saves. I'll radio McGinnis and have them send your car ahead. You mind if I make a comment?
You'll make it anyway, so go ahead.
You should have stuck with no.
Well, you heard the man. I owe him a favor.
Yeah, but it sounds like gumshoe work, and I never heard of $1 million pair of gumshoes. Not to mention the fact that you're not even good at that racket.
You mind if I reply? Point one, to a man like Fitzsimmons, the difference between 10,000 and $1 million is 2 zeros on a piece of paper. Point two, it might not be gumshoe work, so go, Toronto.
We're almost there.
know, there's Neil Fitzsimmons. You started with nothing.
Well, you may be working your way down to that yourself. Mexico was a wipeout, right?
Stop keeping score. It's bad for my ego.
If Canada's another bummer...
I'll get myself a cheaper pilot.
You wouldn't do that.
Why not?
You like the best.
$1,700, the cost of getting your car here, emergency rush.
Go fill your jet, we may be leaving in an hour.
Toronto is one of those beautiful cities I'm always willing to visit, although by the time we arrived, I wasn't sure I wanted to work there. But I'm a working man, and I needed a job. And there aren't too many people around who are willing to hire me. I've been told it has something to do with my fee.